at starlowwithexpressionsvinyl.com. And we have added to our stock some fun new patterns. And I'm going to show you today how to import them into your silhouette program so you have a mock-up. Okay, so as you can see here, I've taken a picture of our unicorn pattern adhesive and just taken it with my phone and made sure that I had plenty of white space, clean background to get a good even color distribution. In the program on your computer, you can actually double click on the picture and it'll take it into this crop space. Then just crop and edit it and bring it as close to the edges as you possibly can so that you get a better accurate reading. All right, just like that. And then select done, and there you go. We're ready to save a copy, and we will just save it to any pattern or any folder onto your computer. I'm just gonna name it Unicorn 12 by 12 Cropped. That's just so I know that that one's ready to go. Okay, and there we have the one ready to be imported in. Okay, in your silhouette program, you're going to actually just drag it in from your file and drop it in the middle. Up at the top here is where you'll adjust your width and your height. Make sure that it's unlocked so you get even sides and just adjust it to 12 by 12. And then relock it. This icon right here will center it to the page, so I'll give you a better visual. All right, so I wanted to use this pattern because it's not symmetrical. Well, it is to a point, but I want to get my unicorn specifically on certain spots. So I'm just gonna drag out, and actually I'm gonna create a 12 by 12 box. This is another method you can do. And I'm going to make that slightly bigger because I did notice that I have some white edges along there. So I am going to place my box over my pattern, and then under the modify window, just use the intersect and crop it. And it's fairly close to how it looks in actual time. And then just resize it to 12 by 12. All right, you wanna do intersect because if you look at the icon, it kind of explains what you want to do. You want your outer image, which is your box, to crop out your background image, leaving the middle. So that's how we got that. And then center it back to your page. All right, and now it's sized and pretty accurate with how it is in real time. Okay, so in my library, I just typed in unicorn, and I have lots of unicorns. So I'm going to use this one. And it'll always import onto the middle of your page, so just slide it off to the side. And then ungroup it. And I like to color them white, and then it doesn't matter on the lines, and then add a little bit of a transparency so you can see your background behind your unicorn. This kind of helps so you can kind of see, do I want it up there, over here? What exactly do I want on my actual unicorn head? And you won't want to adjust the background size at all because this is actually how the vinyl looks in person. And that's what you're trying to duplicate, is what it will actually look like when it's cut. So I'm just going to make it a little bit bigger because I kind of want to get a couple more unicorns into my unicorn head. And about right there looks good. And this red line right there, that is your cut lines. You don't want to go outside of that. That is where your rollers run along the side and they need to stop with about an inch on the end. So if you want to use all of it, be sure to put it on a mat. And I'm just going to color this black so I know that that's what vinyl I'm going to use, or white, just a color. All right, now we're ready to send our job. We have cut settings on our website. And if you don't have these in your program, you can go to add new material type and rename it whatever you want. Just do rename new material. And I'm actually going to name it EV patterned ADH for adhesive. It would be about the same cut settings for the heat transfer as well. So we want to do a blade of a 2, a force of around a 5 or 6, 5. And then I'm going to do my speed a little bit faster because my unicorn is not very detailed and you can go fairly fast with that. All right, and then once you have those settings set, you don't need to use a platform, that's for the curio, and then just hit save. It'll save it, you have to close out of it, and then it should be the very last option in your cut settings, right there. We've got our settings all set up. We're not gonna be using tool 2, so we're just gonna shut that off. And we are using tool 1, so we wanna make sure that our unicorn correlates with the red tool 1. And you are ready to send. Okay, so another option you can use is dragging that file that you cropped with your photo, dragging it into your pattern category in your silhouette library. And you can actually just drag it from the folder and drop it right in. And you have to make sure that it completely uploads, so just give it a minute. All right, and it should be towards the bottom. Right, there it is. Okay, now I always have that pattern in there. I can use that for mock-ups, not for scale mock-ups, if I want to cut in a specific location on the vinyl. This will be more for when I just want to create a mock-up for a visual reference, so I can actually see what the pattern will look like. Okay, so we've got our unicorn again. And to apply the pattern, you can select it, go back into your library, and then click on the pattern. But if you go to your fill pattern option, which is this little painter's palette here, and select this section, this is your pattern option. If you have a lot of patterns, it might take a bit to upload. Just give it a minute. If you don't have as many, it'll be fairly fast. But you should see a section of just the silhouette patterns first. These would be patterns that are pre-programmed into your library. All right, there we are. Those are all pre-programmed. And if you have Designer Edition or higher, you can actually categorize and name all of your patterns, which is a really nice feature. So since this one isn't categorized, when I drop it into my patterns, it should be just under pattern. There it is, the first one. Okay, select your image and select your pattern. And there you go. Because this was a copy from my other file, I left it white as a transparent. So if you've done that, don't wonder why the image is faded. You just need to adjust this transparency. There you go. All right, so this definitely wouldn't be to scale. This would just be for more of a mock-up. You can adjust it with the scale in there, but this would give you a better understanding of what your finished product would look like. All right, I hope everybody found this helpful. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, or if you have any issues with anything. Just let us know and leave them in the comment section below. Thanks, guys. Bye.